Saltshaker friends, Casey here. Welcome to NXTGEN Live. Today, we're going to have an exciting Bible story. But before that, I want you guys to leave your suggestions, comments, and use hashtag NXTGEN Live, hashtag NXTGEN Salt Shakers. Now, who's ready to listen to the Bible story? Are your eyes, ears, and hearts ready? Are you ready? Count down with me. 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1.
Mama, we're rolling already.
Oh my gosh. Oh, okay. Hello, everybody. It's time again for our
Bible story.
And we're really glad mommies and daddies, Lola and Lolo, and all the grown-ups who are out there watching with your kids, we're so glad that you're here to join us. My name is Teacher Maybelle.
And I'm Gavin.
And today we actually have a special guest. And his name is
Baba!
Little Baba, our sheep, is going to be sitting right here. Can you put him over there? Right by our little barn. So, before we begin though, Gavin, I think we need to review what our memory verse is for this month.
Yep.
Okay? So, parents and kids, if you have been looking at our CCF NXTGEN Children's Ministry Facebook page, you might have seen our memory verse over there. But if you haven't, and if you haven't been working on it, it's okay because we can work on it together right now. So let's review what our memory verse is for the month of May. It is John chapter 15, verse 12. This is my commandment, that you love one another just as I have loved you. Okay. You might be wondering how to do the actions. Okay, so let's just go through them one by one. So the word for command, we use our lips to give a commandment, right? We use our mouths to give a commandment. So I give a command to say commandment, we will point first to our lips. You don't want to touch your lips right now though. So just point to your lips and point out to the person you are commanding to. So this is my commandment. Great. That you love. And for the word one another, give me a number one.
One.
Good. And do many ones. One, one, one. So that you love one another. Okay. So when you say just as I, what does that mean, Gavin?
It means in the same way.
In the same way. Yeah. That's right. So the sign language for same is like this. Okay, but we're talking here in our memory verses, we're being the same as Jesus. So let's make it reach from God to us. Okay, so just as I have loved you. Let's go through those actions again. Okay, so John chapter 15, verse 12. This is my commandment. That you love one another just as I have loved you. Let's do that again. John chapter 15, verse 12. This is my commandment, that you love one another just as I have loved you. John chapter 15, verse 12. Great job, kids. So I want you to practice that again, okay, with mommy and daddy. Go through it the whole week because it's a really important memory verse that we have. So, what does our memory verse say about how we are to love one another?
In the same way as Jesus loves us.
That's right. So, Gavin, how are we going to know how Jesus loves us?
By reading about Jesus in the Bible.
Well, that's right. We need to read about how Jesus loves us in the Bible. And that is why we are having our Bible story today, right?
Yep.
Okay, so if you are ready for our Bible story, can you give me an echo? So if I say, echo, you say?
Echo.
If I say, ready, you say?
Ready!
If I say, bah! If I say, meh, you say,
meh.
And now if I say,
again,
you say,
shh.
Okay, I think we're ready to listen. Let's go to our Bible. So our story today is from Matthew chapter 9, verses 35 to 38. Jesus was going through all the cities and villages, one after the other, teaching in those very places where the Jews would come together to worship and study God's words. We call these places synagogues. He was proclaiming the good news of God's kingdom, and he also healed every kind of disease and every kind of sickness. Gavin, do you think that in the synagogues there were just a few people or a lot of people?
A lot of people.
Yes, a lot of people. Can you imagine what it must be like to have all these people begging after you, asking you to heal them one after the other, or begging you to teach more and more?
That's
a lot of work.
Yeah.
Huh? That is a lot of work. I think if I were in Jesus's place, honestly, I think I would be very tired. How about you, Gavin? How would you feel if you were in Jesus's place at that time?
I think I'd feel overwhelmed.
Overwhelmed. Now, I wonder, how did Jesus feel at that time? Let's see what the Bible says. When Jesus saw the crowds, he had compassion on them. That means that he cared very deeply and had a great concern for them. And this was because they were distressed and dispirited, just like sheep without a shepherd. Hold on, what does that look like? It means that the people were full of worry, full of sadness and pain, and they were feeling lost and hopeless. So it's very much like how sheep would be without a shepherd.
Baa!
What's that, Baba?
Baa!
I think Baba wants us to imagine what it would be like for him if he didn't have a shepherd to guide him. I wonder. Oh my, Baba, it's a good thing you do have a shepherd, right?
Baba!
So what does a shepherd do for his sheep, Gavin?
He guides his sheep and he takes care of them.
That's right. So he makes sure that they're well fed. He makes sure that they're getting enough water to drink. And he makes sure that they're growing well and that they're safe, right? So because Jesus saw that the many people around him were like sheep without a shepherd, he had deep love for them. And that is what moved him to keep on teaching, keep on healing, and keep on helping the people around him. But there's something else that Jesus did when he saw all the people in need. He said something to his disciples.
The harvest is plentiful, but the workers are few. So ask the Lord of the harvest to send out workers into his harvest field.
How is the harvest connected to sheep?
Good question, Gavin. During Jesus's time, life for the people there was very different from the one we know now, especially in our cities. There were no malls or big buildings, and they didn't have offices and things like that. No cell phones, no computers. But a lot of them were more like farmers and fishermen. And that's why we often read about Jesus and his disciples helping people understand God's word by connecting his stories to what they do. So, a while ago, we were talking about sheep.
Baa! Baa!
Okay, so a while ago, we were talking about Baba. Now, Jesus is comparing all the people around him with a harvest. We are talking about fruits or vegetables that grow in a farm that are ripe or what we call ready to pick. Gavin, you probably don't remember, but when you were 1 year old, our whole family went to Baguio for strawberry picking. And here's a picture of the strawberry field that we went to. We're showing it on the screen now. And there you are with your big sister, Sophie, picking strawberries and putting them all in your baskets. So in Baguio, you can only go strawberry picking from November to May every year because that is the special season when the strawberries become ripe or ready to be picked. Sometimes it can happen that there's just so many strawberries that are already nice and ripe, ready to be picked, but there's not enough people to pick them in time. So what do you think, Gavin? What's gonna happen to the strawberries that are ripe and ready to be picked, but nobody picks them?
They become rotten and spoiled.
That's right. Or they'll get eaten by birds or worms. So the workers of the farm need to be quick in picking them all in time so they don't lose any of the good ripe strawberries. Just like the harvest season, there will also come a time when Jesus will come again and gather all his followers to join him in his kingdom. Just like a farm owner will gather all the ripe harvest that his workers have picked and placed in their baskets. When the fruits and vegetables are ripe, it's like when people are ready to hear about the good news about Jesus. Now, Gavin, how do all the ripe vegetables and fruits get into the baskets? Do they have legs and then they walk by themselves? Or do they jump one by one into the baskets all by themselves?
No, the farmers pick them up and put them in the baskets.
Okay, so they need the farmers to pick them, right? So that they can get into the baskets. And just like the farm workers, we help Jesus' harvest by sharing about the good news to all the people out there who are ready to listen. Gavin, can you share with us what is the good news anyway?
The good news is that we are loved by God and that we may have sinned. That's not good news. But we have victory through Jesus, and that even though we have sinned, but Jesus died for us, which means he paid for our sins and we can go to heaven. All we need to do is to accept that gift.
The gift of forgiveness that Jesus has given us. So when we accept Jesus' forgiveness, we have that way to be with Jesus in heaven. Thank you so much for that, Gavin. So do you know anyone who might need to hear about this good news?
I know a few people who might need to.
Yeah, well, how about you? Whether you're 4 years old or 9 years old or 99 years old, you probably know some people who need to hear about this good news, right? We've had several weeks of being locked down. And we might know some people who have been sick with the coronavirus. What else can you imagine people might be feeling out there?
They might be feeling helpless.
They might be getting worried that they might get sick.
Yeah.
Or maybe some of them have already lost some loved ones because of the virus. Or maybe some of them are working as frontliners. And, you know, they're working so hard and they're being brave out there, but they're also worried that they might bring home the sickness to their loved ones. You know, a lot of people are having a hard time sleeping also now because of this worry. And don't you think that means that we are ripe? This is a wonderful time for us to be sharing about the good news about Jesus to all of us. As workers of Jesus, we can do our part and reach out and share about Jesus with these people. Sometimes though, honestly, Gavin, when I think about all the people out there who need Jesus, I feel overwhelmed, like the word that you said a while ago, because we can't reach all the people,
yeah,
right?
We can.
Especially during this time of quarantine. But Jesus said something. What did he say to his disciples again after seeing all the people who were like sheep without a shepherd.
To ask the Lord to send more workers to the field.
We ask the Lord. So how do we ask the Lord?
By praying to Him.
Yes. We can pray to Him. We might not be able to reach all the people out there who need to learn about Jesus, but God can send people they need so they can learn about Him. And we can pray and ask God for help. So Jesus is reminding us to pray for more people to share the good news to them. So why don't we pray together now, okay? Dear Jesus, we thank you so much for all the love that you have for us, for the forgiveness that you have given us, for how you love us so much that you want to make sure that we are well cared for. And Lord, we know that there are so many people out there who need to know you. First, Lord, we pray that you help us share the good news to those people that you have allowed us to reach. And for those that we cannot reach, Lord, we pray that you send more workers to your harvest, Lord, so that more people will be able to share the gospel and share the good news with all the people out there who are like sheep without a shepherd, so that more and more people will come to know you and be with you in heaven. All these we pray in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Amen. And that, kids, is the end of our Bible story today. We hope that you liked our Bible story today and learned a lot from it. But don't just let it be a story. Let it plant a seed in your heart and let that grow and use it in your life. So how do we do that? We can take some time to share with one another as a family and talk about how we can use what we learn in our lives today. So we have three questions. First, how do you show compassion for your family and friends? Second, how will you show compassion to those who still don't know Jesus? And third, will you commit to pray for more followers of Jesus to share the gospel to others? So Gavin, may I ask you, can you share with us?
Okay.
So first question, how do you show compassion for your family and friends?
Sometimes I bring up their water bottles or I wash their dishes.
Oh, wow. So the way you help out in the house, right?
Yeah.
Okay. How will you show compassion to those who still don't know Jesus?
Well, we've been packing eggs with gospel tracts so that other people out there on the streets can know Jesus.
Mm-hmm. And third, will you commit to pray for more followers of Jesus to share the gospel?
Yep.
Right. So the people who have been receiving those gospel tracts, we can also keep praying for them, right? That they will come to know Jesus, even if we cannot reach them or meet them ourselves directly, right?
Yeah.
Okay. So kids, take time to share with mommy and daddy, lola, lolo, ate, kuya, the whole family. Just bring them all in and take the time to share with one another so that God's word can bring life into our lives.